Ford is enlisting the minds of the U.S.'s top universities to make self-driving cars a reality. Last month, the company unveiled the Ford Fusion hybrid research vehicle that uses LiDAR sensors to generate a real-time map of its surroundings. The carmaker announced Wednesday that it hopes that researchers at MIT can come up with advanced algorithms to help the vehicle learn to predict where other vehicles and pedestrians could be in the future. For example, if a person is in a crosswalk, the algorithm would assume, like a human, that the person would continue walking along a certain path. The algorithms would also help the car avoid other ones on the road.
So we're using data from the sensors on board and from other sensors that are possibly off board. So there's people talk about sensors that might be sitting at intersections and at stoplights. And so they provide information about both cars and pedestrians that are moving in the vicinity of the car. So then there's the onboard sensors that also give local information. So that data is then processed and into sort of motion patterns and behaviors for these various objects, which are then modeled on board and used to predict sort of where we think these objects are going to be going.
In California, Stanford researchers are tasked with helping cars see around obstacles. When you and I are blocked by a big truck, for example, we might maneuver within the lane to peek around it and see what the holdup is. That's what the self-driving car needs to be taught how to do.
Having the sensors work in all conditions, daylight conditions, night, all weather conditions, these are issues that are fundamental to the problem. We work a lot on planning problems having to do with if you have these models, what can you computationally tractable ways of being able to make these predictions and then use this data. So there's lots of technical issues that still need to be resolved, but we're making great progress, I think.
Automated driving is part of what Ford calls its Blueprint for Mobility, which is attempting to imagine the roads in 2025 and beyond. The company said that it's exploring all the different components of automated driving, including both the technological and legal hurdles. At MIT in Cambridge, I'm Nick Barber, IDG News Service.